Yeah. I don't want to be a one-man band. I don't want to be a rolling stone alone, putting miles on a rundown van. Maybe we could take our own show on the road. I'll lay down the beat, you carry the tune. We'll get tattoos and we'll trash hotel rooms. Baby, take my hand, 'cause I don't want to be a one-man band. I don't want to be a one-man band.
The country you love with a groove. Today's This Country. On River Country.
Takes you groove.
1023.
The future of our community depends on us. Hi, this is Danny Hibbs of Bill Ryan Autoplex in Russellville, and we are proud to support the community calendar and the individuals who give their time and energy to create the future of our children and our grandchildren in the River Valley.
The West.
Live from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, it's time for Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys Basketball. Tonight, the Wonder Boys host the champion Christian College Tigers in non-conference action here on River Country KCJC. Good evening, friends. My name is Sam Streisner. Thank you for joining us. Kelly Davis will be along in just a few minutes. Arkansas Tech evened its 2019-20 record at 1-1 with a 79-59 win over Emporia State University on Saturday. The Wonder Boys' two veterans led them to victory. Senior forward Ramses Sandifer had 20 points and 11 rebounds, while junior guard R.J. Glasper notched 18 points and 8 assists. Champion Christian College competes at the National Christian College Athletic Association level. The Tigers are 2-1 in regular season games this year. On Tuesday, Champion Christian suffered a 96-63 loss to Harding University in what counted as an exhibition game for the Tigers. Thank you for joining us. We will break for 3 minutes and then come back with the starting lineups. This is Arkansas Tech Basketball. It's Arkansas Tech University and Champion Christian College in non-conference men's basketball tonight from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville. If you're not already here or on your way out, we certainly invite you to come out and cheer on the Wonder Boys tonight as they take on Champion Christian for a 6 p.m. contest here on River Country, KCJC, and ArkansasTechSports.com. Time now to take a look at the starters. First for our guests from Hot Springs, the champion Christian College Tigers. They are coached by first-year head coach Leonard Epps. Starting at the guards for Champion Christian, it'll be Derek Gwynn, a 6'3" freshman from Euless, Texas. Stephon Tellis, a 6-foot senior from Phoenix, Arizona. And Jermaruel Norwood, a 5'9" freshman from Fort Smith. The forwards for Champion Christian are Kentrell Jacobs, a 6'4" freshman from Fort Smith, and DeMarcio DeVoyle, a 6'6" senior from Bastrop, Louisiana. Now the starters for the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys, 1-1 on the season. Chad Klein is 85-64 in 6 years as the Arkansas Tech head coach. His assistant coaches are Prince Johnson and Tim Ward. Justin Graham is the graduate assistant. Starting at the guards for Arkansas Tech, Dylan Gooding, 5'10" freshman, Killeen, Texas, 16.5 points, 3.5 rebounds per game. Second guard is Kevin McNeil, a 6'5" senior from San Bernardino, California, 4 points and 3.5 rebounds per game. And the third guard is R.J. Glasper, a 6-foot junior from Forest City, 16.5 points, 2.5 rebounds, 6 assists, and 2 steals per game. The forwards for Arkansas Tech are Ramses Sandifer, a 6'8" senior from Arcola, Mississippi, 17.5 points and 9 rebounds per game. And Devontae Foster, a 6'8" senior from Stockbridge, Georgia, averaging 11 points and 5.5 rebounds per contest. We are joined by Mr. Kelly Davis, the Director of Alumni Relations at Arkansas Tech University. And Kelly, it is a busy night in the Great American Conference, not only in basketball, but from an Arkansas Tech perspective, probably most importantly, in volleyball, as the Golden Suns have a huge match tonight to close out the regular season.
Yes, they do. They have traveled to Magnolia, Arkansas, where they will take on Southern Arkansas University. It's a win and you're in situation. UA Monticello, the other team that they are competing with for that last playoff spot in the GAC tournament, they are traveling to Arkadelphia to take on Ouachita Baptist. It's going to be Harding at Henderson State, Southwest Oklahoma at East Central, Southern Naz at Southeast Oklahoma, and Oklahoma Baptist at Northwest Oklahoma. Also tonight in basketball action, we have one game that's already completed on the women's side. That was Texas A&M Commerce defeating Ouachita Baptist 69-54. Also tonight you have Northwest Oklahoma at Emporia State, East Central is at Tarleton State, and Hendricks is visiting UA Monticello. And on the men's side, you have Oklahoma Baptist at Tarleton State and Dallas Baptist at Ouachita. We'll keep you posted on that volleyball match. We'll pull it up here when they have that first serve and keep you posted on the score throughout the basketball game.
Here at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, it is almost time for non-conference men's basketball between the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys and the champion Christian College Tigers. At this point, we will step aside for a 3-minute break, and when we come back, it'll be time for opening tip. This is Wonder Boys Basketball.
Why trust River Valley Tinting and Glass? Well, River Valley Tinting and Glass is a family-owned business, and they take care of their customers like family, too. So remember, your local auto, residential, and commercial glass and tinting company, River Valley Tinting and Glass. Check out their work on Facebook or call 890-5839 to get an estimate. Or you could always come by 2202 East 2nd Street to see all they can do for you. From a business you can trust, River Valley Tinting and Glass.
Taking care of families. That's what the folks at C&D Drugstore have been doing in historic downtown Russellville for more than 6 decades when it comes to all your pharmaceutical needs. When it comes to compounding special medicines, R.D. Walker and his staff are there to serve you. And most importantly, if you need delivery, if you need curbside pickup, you need C&D Drugstore on the corner of B and Commerce in downtown Russellville, a 60-year tradition.
How can I help you? Can you turn on the porch light? I can't see anything.
Sorry, I didn't get that.
Ow!
Not every innovation is helpful, but the new ITMs at First State Bank can help you achieve your banking needs at the push of a button. Interact with local tellers, cash a check, and more right from your car. Plus, ITMs are open weekdays from 7 to 7. To learn more about First State Bank's new innovative services, go to fsbitm.com.
For over 70 years, Old South Restaurant at 1330 East Main Street in Russellville has been faithfully serving the River Valley. Whether it's starting your day with a good old-fashioned breakfast or helping you make it through the workday with a hearty home-styled lunch, and of course serving your family with a dinner that would even make your mama proud. Old South Restaurant on Main Street in Russellville. We're here for you.
We're here for you, so come on by, Old South.
This is Adam Stoffel with Fill-Rite Autoplex. This month only, up to $8,500 off 2020 Buick Enclaves, or 0% for 72 months on all remaining 2019 models. Or up to $10,000 off 2019 Buick Envisions, or 0% for 72 months. Register to win with your purchase of a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, Toyota, or pre-owned, a 2019 Polaris Sportsman, or Honda Rancher. Up to 30% off 2019 Buick Encores, or 0% for 72 months. Fill-Rite Autoplex, exit 84, just off 540 in Russellville.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service, we're more than just tires. Consistent, responsive, honest and fair. What makes us different? We're the ones who care. Trust our experience to know what you need. Professional and fast, see what we mean. Arkansas Tire and Auto Service. More than just tires.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service, 2304 East Main, Russellville.
Welcome back to Tucker Coliseum in Russellville as we get ready for non-conference men's basketball between Arkansas Tech University and Champion Christian College. Glad to have you with us tonight on River Country KCJC and ArkansasTechSports.com. This will be the third all-time meeting between these two men's basketball programs. Arkansas Tech is 2-0 against Champion Christian, having defeated the Tigers 99-47 on January the 5th of 2010. On that night, it was Laith Massey leading the way with 20 points, 5 rebounds, and 4 assists. Renard Allen added 12 points and 8 rebounds in the Wonder Boys' victory. And then a little bit later, almost 3 years later, in fact, almost 4 years later, the Wonder Boys hosted Champion Christian once again. And on November 25th of 2013, it was the Wonder Boys defeating the Tigers 103-44. On that evening, it was Marshawn Arnold leading the way out of Arkadelphia. He had 19 points and 5 rebounds. And he was a perfect 9 out of 9 from the field. And Kelly, I'm going to guess, I don't remember that game, but I'm going to guess probably a high percentage of those 9 field goal attempts and those 9 makes were probably slam dunks.
I would say you're probably correct on that. We'll say, let's just be nice and say 8 out of 9.
There's a very high likelihood of that. The Wonder Boys wearing the home gold uniforms trimmed in green with white trim around the green numbers. Champion Christian wearing navy blue road uniforms. They have gold numbers and letters outlined in white and some white trim elsewhere on those road jerseys for the Tigers. As we get ready for Arkansas Tech and Champion Christian, this will be the Wonder Boys' final tune-up before the beginning of conference play. They will be idle until next Thursday when they will host Ouachita Baptist, and so this is the final chance to get everything straightened out and ready for the start of Great American Conference play. When you play 22 conference games, as is the case in the Great American Conference, those league games come around awfully quickly. It will be DeMarcio DeVoil against Devontae Foster for the opening tip, and it is controlled by Arkansas Tech. Wonder Boys into the front court. Sandifer passes right wing for Kevin McNeil. McNeil dribbles to his left, gives to R.J. Glasper. Back out front for McNeil. He passes right wing for Dylan Gooding. The Texas State transfer finds Devontae Foster at the right elbow. Zips it down low for Sandifer. Sandifer backs his defender down, misses the layup. Defensive rebound for Champion Christian by Kentrell Jacobs. Into the front court come the Tigers. Pass in the left corner for Derek Gwynn. He has it taken away by Arkansas Tech's Devontae Foster. Fast break opportunity ahead for McNeil on the left wing. He leaves it with Sandifer. Ramsey's for three, no good off the back lip. R.J. Glasper gets the offensive rebound, gives to Gooding for three off the mark. Defensive rebound by Derek Gwynn.
of Champion Christian. Into the front court on the dribble comes Jermaluel Norwood. Norwood defended on the left wing by R.J. Glasper. Passes right wing for Gwynn. Defense there provided by Arkansas Tech's Kevin McNeil. Out front, DeVoyle makes a catch for the Tigers. Feeds it into the post for Gwynn. Turnaround jumper over McNeil is good for Derek Gwynn. Gwynn, who had 10 points on Tuesday night against Harding, gets the first 2 points of this one, and the Tigers lead 2-0. 18:43 to go first half. Foster sets a pick, freeing Gooding to dribble left. Now he gives to Glasper on the right wing. RJ, harassed there by Stephon Tellis, gives to Foster on the right baseline. His jumper is off target, and the defensive rebound taken away for Champion Christian by Kentrell Jacobs. In transition come the Tigers. Left wing Tellis throws it out front to the top of the key for Jacobs. Kentrell Jacobs, three-pointer, no good. Defensive rebound by Kevin McNeil of Arkansas Tech, and the Cal State San Bernardino transfer brings it into the front court for the Wonder Boys. Top of the key, Devontae Foster with it, gives left side, and as R.J. Glasper drives to the basket, a whistle and a foul against Champion Christian's Norwood. Correction, it's going to be on Stephon Tellis instead. It is Tellis' first personal foul, team foul number one, and R.J. Glasper will throw it in from the baseline. Gets it in left side for Gooding. He shoots a long two. It is good. And after four consecutive misses from the field to begin the game for Arkansas Tech, Dylan Gooding gets the Wonder Boys on the board, and we're tied at two.
Just a good open shot that time. Made them pay for it.
Into the front court on the dribble is Jermaruel Norwood. He goes to Tellis at the top of the key. He passes left wing for DeVoyle. Now top of the key, a catch for Derek Gwynn. Gwynn drives, running eight-footer from left. The lane is up and good for Derek Gwynn. It comes at the 17:32 mark of the opening half. And Champion Christian leads 4-2. Gwynn has all four of their points. Three-pointer no good for Devontae Foster of Arkansas Tech, rebounded by Champion Christian. In transition, Tellis for three. No good from the right wing, and Ramsey Sandifer gets the defensive rebound. Ahead it goes on the fast break for Foster. He goes up for the slam dunk and is fouled from behind by DeMarcio DeVoyle. It'll be DeVoyle's first personal, team foul number two, and it will result in two free throw attempts for Arkansas Tech's Devontae Foster.
Well, that foul almost did not pay off the way they wanted it to. He almost made that slam dunk.
Foster, a 6'8" senior forward from Stockbridge, Georgia. Foster had 14 points and 8 rebounds in the Wonder Boys win over Emporia State on Saturday. His first free throw is up and good. Foster now, with that make, 5 out of 7 at the free throw line this season. And now he will have a chance to tie the score here early on in Russellville. The second free throw for Foster is no good. Back lip, rebound, tipped around. It's going to go out of bounds on the baseline. Last touched by Arkansas Tech, and the basketball belongs to Champion Christian. 17 minutes and 7 seconds to go in the first half. Champion Christian 4, Arkansas Tech 3 from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville. Into the front court, Norwood throws it in the right corner for Jacobs. Kentrell Jacobs knocks down the three, his first 3 points of the game. We've played 3 minutes and the Tigers lead 7-3. Right baseline, Gooding, he gets the bounce from 17 feet. It went off the back of the iron and then fell back through for Dylan Gooding. Gooding has four of the Wonder Boys' 5 points, 16:43 to go first half, and Champion Christian has the ball with a two-point lead. Jermaluel Norwood gives it up on the left wing for Jacobs. Jacobs feeling it, back-to-back threes for Kentrell Jacobs of Champion Christian, and the Tigers open up a 10-5 lead after 3.5 minutes. Sandifer passes right wing for Kevin McNeil. Foster slips a screen, McNeil dribbles left, gives to Foster on a pick and pop. Foster picks up his dribble, feeds it in the post for Sandifer. Touch pass out to Glasper. Three-pointer good. R.J. Glasper, with his fifth three-pointer of the season, trims the Champion Christian lead to 10-8. Into the front court, Kentrell Jacobs. Jacobs with it on the left wing. Might have got away with a double dribble. At least that was the feeling on the Arkansas Tech bench. Top of the key, Norwood on the dribble. Freshman from Fort Smith, one of two Fort Smith Northside High School graduates on this Champion Christian roster. A whistle and an illegal screen set by the Tigers. The foul is going to be against Derek Gwynn. It is his first personal foul, team foul number three, and there is timeout on the floor. 15 minutes and 51 seconds to go. First half, Champion Christian 10, Arkansas Tech 8. We break for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Basketball.
James Dunham is experienced, an attorney for 30 years whose practice covers all areas of the law. James Dunham is ethical. He's chairman of the Supreme Court Committee on Professional Conduct. James Dunham is fair. He's known for his respectful treatment of others. He's a man of judicial temperament and sober judgment. Elect James Dunham, Circuit Judge.
Paid for by the Dunham campaign.
Richard Roberts with Cogswell Ford, and we're gearing up for Ford's Black Friday sales event. We've got F-150s with up to $15,000 off. New cars with payments as low as $300 a month. We even have new SUVs starting at $17,900. That's 28% off of MSRP. Kick off your holiday season in a vehicle from Cogswell Ford, where we strive to provide you a simple way of buying, selling, and servicing your vehicle. So visit us today at 1900 East Main in Russell or online at CogswellFord.com.
15 minutes and 51 seconds to go in the first half. Champion Christian 10, Arkansas Tech 8. And following the timeout, the basketball will belong to the Wonder Boys. It'll be Dylan Gooding to bring it into the front court. He passes on the right wing for R.J. Glasper. They reverse it left side for Kevin McNeil. He gets a pick from Sandifer, dribbles right, back to Sandifer in the corner for Gooding. Three-pointer on the way and no good for Dylan Gooding. Defensive rebound by a new face in the game for Champion Christian. That is Corey Griggs, a 6'1 freshman guard from Memphis, Tennessee. And in transition, the Tigers lose it out of bounds, and the basketball goes back to Arkansas Tech. Two turnovers for the Tigers, none so far for the Wonder Boys. R.J. Glasper receives the inbound pass. Glasper came into the night with 1,070 career points at Arkansas Tech. He is the 33rd Wonder Boy to reach 1,000 career points. In a program that dates all the way back to 1914. Three-pointer on the way and good for Glasper. Glasper gets his second three-pointer of the night, accounting for all six of his points. And the Wonder Boys, for the first time tonight, lead at 11-10. Right side with it is Kentrell Jacobs. He gives it up in the corner. Three-pointer short, no good for Gwynn. But there with the offensive rebound and the putback is Kentrell Jacobs. Jacobs has 8 points, and Champion Christian leads 12-11. Drive by McNeil. Lost the handle going up, and the loose ball is taken away for Champion Christian by Stephon Tellis. Fast break opportunity for the Tigers. Into the lane, Tellis. Out it goes left wing for Jacobs. He finds Norwood at the top of the key. Norwood drives, hands it off to Gwynn. Gwynn double-teamed, passes out of trouble to Tellis. Now it goes right wing for Norwood. Back to Jacobs on the right wing. Three-pointer good again for Kentrell Jacobs. Jacobs has 11 points. He is 3 out of 4 from three-point range, and it is 15-11, Champion Christian.
Champion doing a good job right now of ball movement, getting those open shots.
Tigers are 6 out of 9 from the field, including 3 out of 6 from three-point range. Glasper for 3, it rims out, no good. Foster gets the offensive rebound, goes back up with the left hand, and banks it home. Second chance points for Devontae Foster. He has 3 points. Wonder Boys trail by 2. Gwynn, after they beat the press, misses the layup. Sandifer got the defensive rebound, just barely maintains his pivot foot, gets it in the front court for Glasper. Glasper's pass deflected out of bounds by Kentrell Jacobs, and the Wonder Boys will make 3 changes. In for the first time for Arkansas Tech are Kalin Adams, 6'4 junior guard, Pearland, Texas, 2.5 points and 4 rebounds per game. Tony Hall, 6'5 junior guard, Broken Arrow, Oklahoma, 6.5 points, 2.5 rebounds per game. And Kyler Haynes, 6'7 junior forward, Augusta, Georgia, 2 points, 3.5 rebounds per game. Hall for 3, good from the left wing for Tony Hall as he provides the Wonder Boys with some instant offense off the bench and puts Arkansas Tech back in the lead at 16-15.
Good open shot, good spin on the ball.
Whistle and a traveling violation called against Champion Christian's Corey Griggs. A change for the Tigers. In is Cameron Dispuke, a 6-foot freshman guard from Buckner, a graduate of Little Rock Hall High School. And the basketball belongs to Arkansas Tech. R.J. Glasper brings it into the front court. Gives it up out front for Kyler Haynes. Haynes drives into the paint, misses the runner in the lane, gets his own rebound, misses the putback try. Kentrell Jacobs gets the defensive rebound for Champion Christian. Tigers over the timeline with Jermaluel Norwood at the controls. He gives it up right wing for Griggs. Left-handed dribble drive by Griggs. Throws it in the corner. Three-pointer up and good for Jermaluel Norwood. Norwood has his first 3 points of the game, and it is 18-16, Champion Christian. 12:45 to go in the half. Bank shot, no good for Gooding. Rebound, Arkansas Tech. Tony Hall puts it home. 5 points off the bench for Tony Hall. And he ties the score at 18. Full court pressure by the Wonder Boys. Champion Christian beats it. Jacobs has it on the right wing. Passes out front for Griggs. Griggs drives, throws it in the corner for Dismuke. Three-pointer, good again for Champion Christian. The Tigers are 5 out of 8 from beyond the arc, and they lead 21-18 with 12:15 to go in our opening half.
They're lining it up 67% from the field right now.
Top of the key. Ball controlled for Arkansas Tech by Kelan Adams. Now right side for Gooding. Dylan Gooding uses his dribble, throws it out front for R.J. Glasper. Glasper wants to drive, draws a triple team, throws it out to Hall for three. Good again for Tony Hall. Hall with 8 points off the bench, including a pair of three-pointers. And he ties the score at 21 apiece. Into the front court come the Tigers. Next dead ball will be a media timeout. Dribbling on the right wing is Griggs. Corey Griggs brings it back out near midcourt, defended by R.J. Glasper of Arkansas Tech. Griggs gets a high ball screen from Kentrell Jacobs. Haynes takes him on a switch. Out it goes to Jacobs. He'll try another three. And once again, it is good for Kentrell Jacobs. He is 4 out of 5 from three-point range. 14 points for Jacobs and a three-point lead for the Tigers. Left corner, Hall will try to answer. He does. Tony Hall with 11 points. He is 4 out of 4 from the field. 3 out of 3 from three-point range. And champion Christian head coach Leonard Epps wants timeout. 11 minutes and 9 seconds to go. First half, we are tied at 24, back in 1 minute. This is Arkansas Tech basketball.
Maybe you're moving some dirt around the house, got jobs to do, things you need to get finished, and equipment to move. Well, maybe you don't have what you need. River Valley Tractor has it, and they have great prices and great people. Family owned and operated, they treat people like you would expect to treat family. Whatever you're looking for, Kubota has you covered. Construction equipment, farm equipment, zero-turn mowers. Go by today and see the family at River Valley Tractor. 702 Weir Road in Russellville, River Valley Tractor.
Hey guys, Terry Holland here at Best Ride. Did you know Best Ride's been in business for 15 years? We are still offering the same great customer service we started with in 2004. We started with an affordable car with 24 months or 24,000-mile service contract with a low interest rate. We helped with your sales tax, gave free oil changes to the length of the contract, and reported credit. Best Ride now offers a little more. We have a full service department with all your vehicle needs, a service contract with no deductible, a newer, lower mile vehicle to choose from. Best Ride's been serving the River Valley for 15 years. You can find us at BestRideArkansas.com, Instagram, and Facebook. So guys, come see us at 621 South Knoxville in Russellville.
Champion Christian, 9 out of 13, 69% from the field so far. Arkansas Tech, 9 out of 20, 45%. The Tigers have connected on 6 of 9 tries from three-point range. That's 67%. Arkansas Tech, 50% from beyond the arc, 5 out of 10. And Champion Christian has a 9-7 rebounding edge. The Wonder Boys are +3 on the turnover margin. Full court pressure by the Wonder Boys. Champion Christian able to beat it into the front court. DeAndre Butler in for the first time. Passes ahead for Cameron Dismuke. Dismuke defended on the right wing by Arkansas Tech's Kalen Adams. Picks up his dribble, does Dismuke, and hands it off to his teammate, Jermeluel Norwood. Norwood dribbles left. He's got it on the Tech logo at midcourt with 10 to shoot, defended by Dylan Gooding. Passes right wing, runner by Jacobs, off the window, and good for Kentrell Jacobs. He's got 16 points in the first 9 minutes and 18 seconds, and champion Christian leads 26-24.
He's just a pure shooter.
In for the first time for Arkansas Tech is Albert Odero. He gives left wing for Adams. His bank shot from 10 feet away is no good. Defensive rebound by Norwood for the Tigers. Ahead to Dismuke. He'll try a three. It is no good from the right wing. And Tony Hall has the defensive rebound for Arkansas Tech. 10 minutes and 14 seconds to go. First half. Gooding drives. Layup will not go. Rebound tipped around. Controlled for Arkansas Tech by Kyler Haynes. Putback try is no good. And Dismuke comes away with the defensive rebound for champion Christian. Pull up three by Jacobs. Why not? Kentrell Jacobs is 5 out of 6 from three-point range. He's 7 out of 8 from the field. He has scored 19 points in 10 minutes and 8 seconds. And he has champion Christian out in front, 29-24, midway through the first half.
Woo! Somebody get a water hose on him.
And he had a hand in his face that time. Gooding shoots a long two. It's no good. Offensive rebound and a putback try by Kalen Adams is no good. Champion Christian gets the rebound. Outlet pass for DeAndre Butler. His pass is deflected. It was going to go out of bounds, and it does. It was last touch by Arkansas Tech. I was afraid that Cameron Dispute, from, I was afraid for Champion Christian, that Cameron Dispute was going to reach out and touch that ball.
He was thinking about it. He thought about it real hard.
He thought better of it, and as a result, the basketball will stay with the Tigers. Changes for the Wonder Boys. Let's reset the lineup. It's Devontae Foster, R.J. Glasper, Tony Hall, Albert Odero, and Kalen Adams. Now the five on the floor for Arkansas Tech. Didn't get a chance to properly introduce Albert. Albert Odero is a 6'4" junior guard from Wanata, New York. He averages 2 points and 2.5 rebounds per game. Inbound pass will be made for Champion Christian by Corey Griggs. With 22 on the shot clock, he gets it in to DeAndre Butler. Butler had 14 points at Harding on Tuesday night. He backs his defender down, draws a triple team now, tries to throw it out. Ball is deflected, saved for Champion Christian by Stephon Tellis. Tellis gives it up, left corner for Dismuke. Three-pointer is in and out, no good. Rebound for Arkansas Tech by Devontae Foster. Foster brings it over the timeline, finds a guard, gives to Glasper. Glasper penetrates, shoots over Dismuke, no good. Defensive rebound for Champion Christian by Arian Williams. In transition, layup try, no good. Devontae Foster forced the Corey Griggs miss and rebounded it. And then the outlet pass gets away from R.J. Glasper out of bounds. Arkansas Tech commits the turnover, and the basketball belongs to Champion Christian with 8 minutes and 46 seconds to go in the first half, and the Tigers leading the Wonder Boys by a score of 29-24. Kelly, how are things going in that volleyball match?
Well, volleyball right now, still in the first set, 18-16. The Golden Suns have the lead right now.
That's a win, and you're into the postseason situation for head coach Kara Dukic and the Golden Suns volleyball team. As a foul is called against Arkansas Tech, it's on Kalen Adams. It is his first personal foul, the first team foul against Arkansas Tech. And Champion Christian will throw it in from the far side. It'll be Arian Williams to throw it in. He is a 6-foot freshman guard from Dallas, Texas. Williams had 7 points when Champion Christian took on Harding University 48 hours ago. Top of the key, Williams with it, passes left wing, dribble drive by Stephon Tellis. He misses the runner too hard, and it's a rebound for Arkansas Tech's Tony Hall. Hall into the front court, pulls up, left of center, the top of the key, misses a three-pointer. Rebound out of bounds, last touched by Devontae Foster of Arkansas Tech. Back in after a brief rest is Kentrell Jacobs. They don't want to leave him out for too long the way he's shooting
it. No,
they
don't.
19 of their 29 points.
He's on fire right now.
After a quick breather, he's right back in. Jacobs, a freshman from Fort Smith, Arkansas, where he played high school basketball under the direction of Eric Burnett, an Arkansas Tech alumnus and member of the Arkansas Tech Board of Trustees. Champion Christian beats the full court press. They get it ahead to DeMarcio DeVoyle. He misses the layup. On the rebound, there's a whistle, there's a foul, and it appears that it will be against Arkansas Tech. Got a hack across the wrist on Arkansas Tech's Tony Hall, his first, team's second, and to the free throw line for Champion Christian goes Stephon Tellis. Tellis looking for his first point of the night. He had 4 points and 5 rebounds against Harding on Tuesday night, did not attempt a free throw in that one. He makes the first one. That's the first point for either side in almost 2 minutes, which is news, the rate at which these two teams scored through the first 10 minutes. He gets both of those, and Champion Christian has its largest lead of the night, a 7-point spread, as we go under 8 minutes to play in the first half. Left wing, Tony Hall dribbles right, gets to the right elbow, throws it out right wing for Odero. He takes it to the rim and gets fouled going in for the slam dunk try. Odero will shoot 2 free throws when we come back. The foul on DeMarcio DeVoyle is his second and the team's fourth. 7 minutes and 49 seconds to go. First half, Champion Christian 31, Arkansas Tech 24. We break for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Basketball.
Parents have a hard job. How do you feed the kids good food without breaking the bank? When you dine in at Steak and Shake on Saturday and Sunday, kids eat free with every $9 spent, and your food is always made to order. Steak and Shake on Parkway Drive.
Steak and Shake's reward app makes saving super easy. Download the Steak and Shake Rewards app for free. Then order and pay from your device or smartphone, and every $50 that you spend, you get $5 in rewards. Steak and Shake on Parkway Drive. Miller Roofing Company. They've been serving our neighbors in the River Valley since 1991. Miller Roofing offers residential and commercial roofs in a variety of styles, pitched, flat roofs, and more, plus a wide variety of materials, tile, shingles, metals, you name it. Also at Miller Roofing, they do chimney caps, wood repair, they work on your gutters, they do custom metal fabrication, chimney flashing, and tons more. So get a quote today from Miller Roofing. They're not just good. They're great. 479-890-3499.
7 minutes and 49 seconds to play in our first half. Champion Christian College 31, Arkansas Tech University 24. Glad that you are with us tonight on River Country KCJC and ArkansasTechSports.com. We'll be with you again on Saturday afternoon for Wonder Boys football as Arkansas Tech will close out the 2019 season by taking on Harding University for a 2 p.m. Great American Conference contest at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. Pre-game coverage will begin on River Country KCJC at 1:30 p.m. on Saturday afternoon. Albert Odero out of the timeout makes both free throws, and with 7 minutes and 49 seconds to go in the first half, the champion Christian lead is 5, 31-26. Odero gets a breather. Ramsey Sandifer, Devontae Foster, R.J. Glasper, Dylan Gooding, and Kevin McNeil are the five on the floor for Arkansas Tech as head coach Chad Klein has his starting five together again. A drive and a blocking foul against Arkansas Tech's Ramsey Sandifer as he tried to defend the dribble drive by DeAndre Butler. Instead, Sandifer picks up the foul, his first, team foul number three. And champion Christian will throw it in from the baseline with 20 on the shot clock.
Not sure how much more still you can be and straight up.
Inbound pass comes to DeMarcio Devoil. Butler dribbles left. Feed into the low post for Devoil. Devoil's layup try blocked by McNeil. Rebounded by Sandifer. Wonder Boys take it the other way. Down by five. 7:25 to go first half. Sandifer for three. No good. Tip try by Foster. No good. Rebound out of bounds. And it was last touched by champion Christian's DeAndre Butler. The basketball will stay with the Wonder Boys. The shot clock is put at 20 since it is an offensive rebound.
Yes, Foster staying very active around the rim. Couldn't get that one to fall.
Changes for the Tigers as Jermaluel Norwood returns, as does Derek Gwynn. Inbound pass, left elbow. For Arkansas Tech's Devontae Foster, spin move in the lane, fadeaway jumper from 12 feet, would not go. Rebound, fought for, and it is champion Christian College's Kentrell Jacobs who comes away with the loose ball. Into the front court come the Tigers. Right corner on the dribble, Stephon Tellis. Tellis defended by Dylan Gooding. Passes right corner for DeMarcio Devoil. Devoil defended by Arkansas Tech's Devontae Foster, gives it up to Gwynn. He misses a long two from the right wing. Defensive rebound for Arkansas Tech by Devontae Foster. Into the front court, McNeil stops on the left baseline, throws it out on the wing for Sandifer. He knocks it down. An 18-foot jumper from the left wing for Ramses Sandifer. Sandifer gets his first 2 points of the game, and it is 31-28. That snaps a string of 9 consecutive missed field goal attempts for Arkansas Tech. Left wing on the dribble. For champion Christian, it is Jamariel Norwood. Norwood defended by R.J. Glasper, turns the corner, and a hand check foul against Arkansas Tech's R.J. Glasper. It is Glasper's first personal foul. It is team foul number four. The two sides are now even in that regard. And the basketball will be thrown in from the baseline by Stephon Tellis. 6 minutes and 24 seconds to go. First half, champion Christian 31, Arkansas Tech 28. Cameron Dismuke returns for the Tigers. And DeMarcio Devoil gets a breather. Inbound pass. Deflected by Dylan Gooding. Stolen for Arkansas Tech by Ramsey Sandifer. Wonder Boys into the front court. Glasper tries to drive. Cut off. Steps back for three. Misses. Rebound. Derek Gwynn. And he is fouled on a push from behind against Arkansas Tech's Kevin McNeil. I believe. Oh, maybe not. Did they call a held ball there?
No, they called it. The foul. He just pointed the wrong way.
Okay. It is going to be.
It was on number 10.
It is McNeil. On Kevin McNeil, his first personal, and team foul number 5. Could have on a, 25-75 shot, could have called it a held ball instead of a foul, but it was definitely a push from behind and a good call on the foul against Arkansas Tech's Kevin McNeil, even though we don't like it.
Can't argue it, though. Well, we can, but it won't do any good.
No. We'll save that for later. Left corner, Derek Gwynn with it. He drives, dishes out right side for Dismuke. Dismuke drives, runs over a defender, and an offensive foul is called on Cameron Dismuke. There to take the charge for Arkansas Tech was Kevin McNeil. And the turnover against champion Christian gives the basketball back to Arkansas Tech with 5 minutes and 55 seconds to go in the half. And champion Christian leading 31-28. The foul on Dismuke is his first. It is team foul number 5. Into the front court on the dribble comes Dylan Gooding. Gooding averaging 16.5 points per game so far this year. He has 4 points tonight. McNeil for three. Good. No, they're going to say a two. He had a toe on the line from the far side. So a long two for McNeil cuts the champion Christian lead down to a single point at 31-30. Right corner, Cameron Dismuke with it. They reverse it left side for Gwynn. Gwynn has Dismuke cutting through, gives it to him. Ball fake, kicks it out to Tellis. Tellis defended by Glasper, wants to drive, gets into the lane. Running 10-footer is good for Stephon Tellis. Tellis has 4 points. That's his first made field goal of the night. 5:15 to go in the half. Tigers by three. Right baseline. Foster goes to the rim and stuffs it through with the left hand. Devontae Foster with the slam dunk, and he pulls the Wonder Boys back within one. 5 points for Devontae Foster. Left wing Dismuke thought about a three. Now he drives. Defender fell down. Foster with the help defense blocks the shot and rebounds it. Goes behind the back with the dribble into the front court. Stops in the left wing. Spin move. Penetrates. Kicks out to Gooding for three. It is no good. Defensive rebound. Kentrell Jacobs. This Arkansas Tech crowd is ready to come unglued.
Oh, they are.
If that three had gone in, because Devontae Foster put on quite a show to get it there. Now champion Christian wants to slow it down for just a moment. Jacobs sets a pick. Receives a pass on the right wing now. Receiving that pass from Jamaruel Norwood. Pass on the left wing for Dismuke. 9 to shoot. He gives it up to Jamaruel Norwood. Norwood penetrates. Pass deflected by Foster. Tigers save it. They give to Gwynn. Layup good with 2 on the shot clock. From the left baseline, Gwynn lays it up and in. And champion Christian leads 35-32 as we creep up on 4 minutes to play in this first half.
That was a good move not to pick up a charge foul.
6 points for Derek Gwynn. Three-pointer is off to the right. No good for Kevin McNeil. Defensive rebound by Kentrell Jacobs. That's his 7th rebound to go along with 19 points for the freshman from Fort Smith. Pass out of bounds. Turnover, champion Christian, and the Wonder Boys will have it when we come back. 3 minutes and 46 seconds to go. First half, champion Christian leads 35-32. Back in 1 minute, this is Arkansas Tech basketball.
This is Todd Bimerstorf, Market President with Centennial Bank, and one of the best things about being a community-focused bank like Centennial is that we can focus on what matters, real relationships. That means the focus is on you as the customer. At Centennial Bank, we're real bankers helping people by building real relationships. Come see for yourself the difference our real commitment can make. Stop by any of our local branches in Russellville, Adkins, Pottsville, Clarksville, or Dardanelle, or if you prefer, experience us online at my100bank.com. Centennial Bank. Member FDIC.
Corey Beeson and the folks at Beeson Roofing Solutions are proud to support local sports in the River Valley. And they also want to say a special thank you to all their loyal customers and the community for their business. So if you have a problem with your roof, whether it be on your home or business, visit BeesonRoofing.com to see their work or call 967-2288 to schedule a free estimate or second opinion today from your local roofing experts, Beeson Roofing Solutions.
3 minutes and 46 seconds to go in the first half. Champion Christian 35, Arkansas Tech 32. Glad you are with us tonight on River Country, KCJC, and ArkansasTechSports.com.
In that first set, the Golden Suns won that one. I will say they did. It's 24-23 posting, but they have given us the win, so I'll say it was 25-23. And now they're in the second set. We're leading 5-2.
Dylan Gooding, Devontae Foster, R.J. Glasper, Ramsey Sandifer, and Tony Hall, the 5 on the floor for Arkansas Tech following the under 4 media timeout. Champion Christian leading 35-32. Ball out of bounds off the foot of Arkansas Tech guard Dylan Gooding. The Wonder Boys commit just their second turnover of the game. And the basketball goes back to the Tigers with 3.5 minutes to go until the intermission. Into the front court on the dribble comes Jamariel Norwood. Norwood defended by Devontae Foster, throws it away, pass stolen by Dylan Gooding. It's a 3-on-2, Gooding to Foster, slam dunk in transition for Devontae Foster. He's got 7 points, 3 minutes and 12 seconds to play in the half, and the Wonder Boys are once again back within 1 point of the lead, but Champion Christian now has held the lead for 7.5 minutes without relinquishing it.
Well, Foster has become the fan favorite so far right now tonight.
Jermaluel Norwood on the dribble for Champion Christian. Defended for Arkansas Tech by Devontae Foster. Drive and a hand check foul against Arkansas Tech's Devontae Foster as he got caught in a bit of a quickness mismatch there. The foul on Foster is his first. Team foul number 6. The next one will put Champion Christian into the bonus. Changes for Arkansas Tech. As back in for the Wonder Boys is Killen Adams, replacing Devontae Foster. Dribbling on the left wing for Champion Christian is Stephon Tellis. He drives and took one step too many, but they're going to call him for an offensive foul. Before that, they're going to say he pushed
off.
Off
arm.
Pushed off on the defender before he walked. The foul is on Stephon Tellis, his second personal foul. Team foul number 6, and the basketball goes to Arkansas Tech.
Golden Suns are settling in now. It's 9-2 in the second set with the lead.
Win in that match puts the Golden Suns into the GAC volleyball tournament, which begins next Thursday night at Bank OZK Arena in Hot Springs. Left wing, Sandifer for 3. It is no good. Offensive rebound, Adams. Killen Adams shoots from the right wing, 10 feet away, no good. Defensive rebound by Kentrell Jacobs, and Jacobs closing in on a double-double. He's got 19 points and 8 rebounds. Into the front court on the dribble comes Corey Griggs. Nobody stops the ball. He lays it up and in. Griggs has his first 2 points. 2 minutes and 11 seconds to go in the first half. And it's 37-34, Champion Christian. Hall for 3, no good from the right wing. Defensive rebound for Champion Christian by Jermaluel Norwood. In transition, it goes left corner for Griggs. He drives the baseline. Reverse layup, no good. Tip is good for Derek Gwynn. Gwynn has 8 points. He's 4 out of 7 from the field. 1:50 to go in the half. Champion Christian by 5. Left wing Gooding tries to drive, cut off by Gwynn. Passes right wing for R.J. Glasper. Glasper defended by DeAndre Butler. Out front it goes to Killen Adams. Back to Glasper on the right wing. Glasper shoots a long 2. It is good. Had a toe on the line. R.J. Glasper has 8 points. 1:25 to go in the half. And the Wonder Boys trail 39-36. Glasper now 3 out of 6 from the field after knocking down that long 2-pointer. Now a steal by Dylan Gooding and a clear path to the basket. He lays it up and in. Gooding has 6 points. Back-to-back buckets for the Wonder Boys. It's 39-38, Champion Christian. 1 minute to play in the first half. Top of the key, Butler. Defended by Glasper. Dribbles right. Spin move. He shuffled his pivot foot. And it's a traveling violation against Champion Christian and a chance for the Wonder Boys to take the lead for the first time since it was 16-15 with 13:37 to play in this first half. The Wonder Boys so far in this game have only led for 1 minute and 3 seconds out of the first 19 minutes of this contest. Glasper has it poked away. Able to get it back though. Shot clock at 20. RJ drives, gets to the rim, layup good for RJ Glasper. 10 first half points for the junior from Forest City and a 1 point lead for the Wonder Boys. Their first lead in almost 13 minutes of game action. Champion Christian throws it away. Turnover number 11 for the Tigers and a fine play made on the weak side of the floor by my friend Kelly Davis.
Good thing that thing slowed down. Already hit me right in the forehead.
Glasper will walk it over the timeline for Arkansas Tech and the Wonder Boys will hold for the final shot of the half. I knew you had it all the way. Glasper dribbles on the Tech logo at midcourt.
I would have had the rock right across it, my head.
Well, it would have been an improvement.
Yeah.
Defended by Corey Griggs.
Temporary tattoo.
Glasper now with 10 seconds left in the half. Looks to drive. 5 seconds left in the half. Glassberg gets into the lane, dishes for Adams. He stuffs it through with 2 seconds left in the half. The Wonder Boys close the half on an 8-0 run. And as a result, our score at halftime is Arkansas Tech 42, Champion Christian 39. We pause for 3 minutes. This is Wonder Boys basketball.
How many times have you had to go without your heating or your air unit when you needed it most? Your family's freezing or sweating and they look to you for relief. You call someone and they say it's going to cost an arm and a leg to fix. Do you really feel like you have a choice? Well, now you do. Call Tony at Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air at 479-964-4004 for a free second opinion from a guy you can trust to take care of you and your family and get that unit running without all the extra charges. Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air.
Fellner's Athletes Corner, your high-performance athletic store for quality athletic footwear and apparel, features Nike, Under Armour, The North Face, Patagonia, Oakley, Saucony, New Balance, Brooks, Asics, Kavu, Keen, and many, many more. Fellner's invites you to make them your first stop. With more than 50 years combined experience, the familiar faces at Fellner's can help you with all your athletic needs. Fellner's Athletes Corner, 2320 West Main, Russellville, open 9:30 until 6, Monday through Saturday.
Hey, it's Drew Mitchell for Lakeside Oral, Facial, and Dental Implant Surgery. Lakeside is really proud this year to be sponsoring our local sports all throughout the River Valley. They're committed to the area. It's just another way they show that. When you're in the market for dentures, wisdom teeth, or whatever the case may be, remember Lakeside Oral, Facial, and Dental Implant Surgery and check out their website at lakesideofs.com. Lakeside Oral Surgery, helping make the broadcast of local sports throughout the River Valley possible.
Joshua's Fine Jewelry, a luxury establishment in the heart of downtown Russellville, are taking it back to the good old days with a family-owned, family-operated business that pride themselves on personal interactions, beautiful custom craftsmanship, and an insanely knowledgeable and helpful staff that go above and beyond just for you. Joshua's Fine Jewelry is giving a huge shout-out to all of our local River Valley and Natural State athletes. You guys are the real MVPs. Be sure to like Joshua's Fine Jewelry on Facebook today and go and give them a visit in downtown Russellville at 310 West Main Street.
Did you know if your roof isn't maintained regularly, you could void the warranty on your existing roof? Tim Noblett with E&F Roofing has made it his mission to protect your roof or help you get the new roof that will maximize your investment and extend the life of your roof, which can save you money through prevention and maintenance. So before you have another company check your roof, call 479-272-4069 and let E&F Roofing see what they can find and how much you can save by using someone local, someone who cares, right here in the River Valley. Why trust River Valley Tinting and Glass? Well, River Valley Tinting and Glass is a family-owned business, and they take care of their customers like family, too. So remember, your local auto, residential, and commercial glass and tinting company, River Valley Tinting and Glass. Check out their work on Facebook or call 890-5839 to get an estimate. Or you could always come by 2202 East 2nd Street to see all they can do for you. From a business you can trust, River Valley Tinting and Glass.
Back with you at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, where we are at halftime and Arkansas Tech leads Champion Christian 43-39 in non-conference men's basketball action. I have some good news for you. You might notice that's a different score than we had when we went to commercial break. They conducted a video review right as halftime was beginning. They went back and looked at that RJ Glasper, that long jumper from just right of center at the top of the key that came with 1 minute and 25 seconds left, and they changed that from a two-pointer to a three-pointer, and so as a result, that half-ending run for the Wonder Boys turned out to be 9-0 on that run to close out the half, and so the Wonder Boys lead 43-39 at the intermission. Let's take a look at the numbers so far. Arkansas Tech is 17 of 43 from the field, 40%, including 6 out of 18, 33% from three-point range. And the Wonder Boys are 3 out of 4, 75% at the free throw line. Champion Christian, 15 of 28 from the field, 54%, including 7 out of 12, 58% from three-point range. The Tigers have made both of their free throws. Champion Christian with a 22-18 rebounding edge But right now, the reason the Wonder Boys have been able to reclaim the lead is turnover margin. 11 turnovers in that first half for Champion Christian, just 2 for Arkansas Tech. The Wonder Boys have a 13-0 edge in points off turnovers, and that's the number one reason why Arkansas Tech has a 43-39 lead at the intermission. Individual leaders, first for Champion Christian, it's Kentrell Jacobs with 19 points. Derek Gwynn has 8 points for the Tigers. 4 points at halftime for Stefan Tellis. Jermelual Norwood has 3 points, as does Cameron Dismuke, and 2 points at halftime for Corey Griggs. Arkansas Tech led by R.J. Glasper and Tony Hall with 11 points apiece. Devontae Foster has 7 points and 6 rebounds. 6 points for Dylan Gooding. And then Arkansas Tech has gotten 2 points apiece from Ramses Sandifer, Kalen Adams, Kevin McNeil, and Albert Odero. Arkansas Tech leads 43-39 at halftime. We pause for 3 minutes and then come back with a look at what else is going on around the Great American Conference. This is Wonder Boys Basketball.
Taking care of families. That's what the folks at C&D Drugstore have been doing in historic downtown Russellville for more than 6 decades when it comes to all your pharmaceutical needs. When it comes to compounding special medicines, R.D. Walker and his staff are there to serve you. And most importantly, if you need delivery, if you need curbside pickup, you need C&D Drugstore on the corner of B and Commerce in downtown Russellville, a 60-year tradition.
How can I help you?
Can you turn on the porch light? I can't see anything.
Sorry, I didn't get that.
Ow!
Not every innovation is helpful. But the new ITMs at First State Bank can help you achieve your banking needs at the push of a button. Interact with local tellers, cash a check, and more, right from your car. Plus, ITMs are open weekdays from 7 to 7. To learn more about First State Bank's new innovative services, go to fsbitm.com.
For over 70 years, Old South Restaurant at 1330 East Main Street in Russellville has been faithfully serving the River Valley. Whether it's starting your day with a good old-fashioned breakfast or helping you make it through the workday with a hearty home-styled lunch, and of course serving your family with a dinner that would even make your mama proud. Old South Restaurant on Main Street in Russellville. We're here for you.
We're here for you, so come on by Old South.
This is Adam Stoffel, Fill-Rite Autoplex. This month only, up to $8,500 off 2020 Buick Enclaves, or 0% for 72 months on all remaining 2019 models. Or up to $10,000 off 2019 Buick Envisions, or 0% for 72 months. Register to win with your purchase of a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, Toyota, or pre-owned, a 2019 Polaris Sportsman, or Honda Rancher. Up to 30% off 2019 Buick Encores, or 0% for 72 months. Fill-Rite Autoplex, exit 84, just off I-40 in Russellville.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service, we're more than just tires. Consistent, responsive, honest and fair. What makes us different? We're the ones who care. Trust our experience to know what you need. Professional and fast, see what we mean. Arkansas Tire and Auto Service.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service, 2304 East Main, Russellville.
James Dunham is experienced, an attorney for 30 years whose practice covers all areas of the law. James Dunham is ethical. He's chairman of the Supreme Court Committee on Professional Conduct. James Dunham is fair. He's known for his respectful treatment of others. He's a man of judicial temperament and sober judgment. Elect James Dunham, Circuit Judge.
Paid for by the Dunham Campaign.
Halftime at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, and the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys lead the Champion Christian Tigers by a score of 43-39. Here with a look at what else is going on tonight in Arkansas Tech Athletics and in the Great American Conference is Mr. Kelly Davis.
Well, let's talk volleyball right now. The Golden Suns in the second set have a 21-14 lead over Southern Arkansas. So they already have a 1-0 set lead. So the second set looks pretty promising right now. We'll see how that continues. In other action around the league tonight, you have UA Monticello at Ouachita, Harding at Henderson State, Southwest Oklahoma at East Central, Southern Nazarene at Southeast Oklahoma, Oklahoma Baptist at Northwest Oklahoma State. That's in volleyball action. In women's basketball, one that has already gone final, they played this afternoon. It was Texas A&M Commerce 69, Ouachita Baptist 54. Other three games in action in women's basketball tonight. We do not have stats available, but Northwest Oklahoma is at Emporia State, East Central at Tarleton State, Hendricks at UA Monticello. In men's action, you have Oklahoma Baptist visiting Tarleton State, and Dallas Baptist is in Arkadelphia visiting Ouachita. Let's talk a little football action right now. This coming Saturday is the last Saturday of regular season action in the Great American Conference. You have the Harding Bisons coming to town, and they are 9-1 in the conference, needing a big win to keep that playoff hope alive over Arkansas Tech. Also, the big matchup of the Saturday games, you have Henderson State walking across the street to Ouachita Baptist. Henderson State 9-1, Ouachita 10-0. Henderson State looking for a share of that GAC conference championship with a win. UA Monticello 5-5 on the season at Southern Arkansas, who is 7-3. Oklahoma Baptist 6-4 on the year is visiting Southern Nazarene. They are 2-8. East Central, also 2-8, is visiting Southeast Oklahoma 1-9 on the season. And Southwest Oklahoma 3-7, visiting 3-7 Northwest Oklahoma. It is rival weekend in the GAC football championship series. So it's important. Maybe Arkansas Tech become the spoiler and spoil Harding's bid for a playoff. Harding has a lot to play for, Sam. If they win, probably more than likely, they will host a first-round playoff game in football action. And if Henderson State wins and Ouachita and they both go to 10-1, it's going to be very interesting. Right now, Henderson State is the number 7 playoff spot, which is the last one. Only 7 from the 4 regions go. And Henderson State needs a win to remain in the playoffs. And so if Ouachita takes care of business, Henderson more than likely be out of the playoff hunt with a great 9-2 season. But they're wanting that 10-1 mark.
Well, and whoever ends up being the odd team out from the Great American Conference, of course, will be a likely candidate to represent Arkansas Tech in the Live United Texarkana, or excuse me, I said Arkansas Tech, represent the Great American Conference, I should say. Whoever, among Harding, Henderson State, and Ouachita, whoever doesn't make it into the Division II playoffs will likely represent the Great American Conference in the Live United Texarkana Bowl.
And very possibly Southern Arkansas, if they get a win, they'll be 8-3, and they might have a shot at another bowl game. That is, that will be held sometime after the regular season.
Here at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, we've got 20 minutes of regulation basketball remaining tonight. Our score at halftime is Arkansas Tech 43, Champion Christian 39. Back in 2 minutes with the second half. This is Wonder Boys Basketball.
Brady Dorse with Cogsville Motors Pre-Owned and Cogsville Select. Now's the time to get the best deals on quality pre-owned vehicles. We've marked down hundreds of vehicles to give you the best deal in the River Valley, so hurry in because these deals won't last long. Come check out our year-end sales event going on now until December 31st. So shop Cogsville Motors, where we look to provide you with a simple way of buying, selling, and servicing your vehicle. Visit us at 1900 East Main in Russellville or online at CogsvilleMotors.com.
Maybe you're moving some dirt around the house, got jobs to do, things you need to get finished, and equipment to move. Well, maybe you don't have what you need. River Valley Tractor has it, and they have great prices and great people. Family owned and operated, they treat people like you would expect to treat family. Whatever you're looking for, Kubota has you covered. Construction equipment, farm equipment, zero turn mowers. Go by today and see the family at River Valley Tractor. 702 Weir Road in Russellville, River Valley Tractor.
Hey guys, Terry Holland here at Best Ride. Did you know Best Ride's been in business for 15 years? We are still offering the same great customer service we started with in 2004. We started with an affordable car for 24 months or 24,000 mile service contract with a low interest rate. We helped with your sales tax, gave free oil changes to the length of the contract, and reported credit. Best Ride now offers a little more. We have a full service department with all your vehicle needs, a service contract with no deductible, a newer lower mile vehicle to choose from. Best Ride's been serving the River Valley for 15 years. You can find us at BestRideArkansas.com, Instagram, and Facebook. So guys, come see us at 621 South Knoxville in Russellville.
Parents have a hard job. How do you feed the kids good food without breaking the bank? When you dine in at Steak and Shake on Saturday and Sunday, kids eat free with every $9 spent, and your food is always made to order. Steak and Shake on Parkway Drive.
Steak and Shake's reward app makes saving super easy. Download the Steak and Shake Rewards app for free. Then order and pay from your device or smartphone, and every $50 that you spend, you get $5 in rewards. Steak and Shake on Parkway Drive.
KCJC, Darknell, Russellville.
Hey! You guys play the best country of all.
River Country. KCJC.
Back with you from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville as we get ready for Great American, or I should say non-conference men's basketball second half here tonight between Arkansas Tech and Champion Christian. Glad to have you with us on River Country, KCJC, and ArkansasTechSports.com. For Champion Christian to begin the second half, it'll be Stephon Tellis, Jermelluel Norwood, along with Dermarchio DeVoyle, Kentrell Jacobs, and Derek Gwynn. For Arkansas Tech, it'll be Dylan Gooding, Ramsey Sandifer, Devontae Foster, R.J. Glasper, and Kevin McNeil. Tigers with the basketball. They find Tellis cutting to the rim. He misses the layup. Defensive rebound for Arkansas Tech by Ramsey Sandifer. Wonder Boys into the front court, up by four early in the second half. Closed the first half on a 9-0 run, looking to carry that momentum over to the second half. McNeil drives, loses the handle going up, and he was bailed out by a foul committed by Champion Christian. Foul will be on Jermelluel Norwood. It is his first personal foul. It is team foul number one. Inbound pass for Sandifer. He got away from his defender and laid it up and in. Ramsey Sandifer has 4 points. That's 11 straight points by Arkansas Tech, dating back to the end of the first half. And it's 45-39, Wonder Boys. A whistle and an offensive foul against Champion Christian. They have got Jermalle Norwood.
That's two quick ones.
Norwood gets his second. And it is team foul number two, and the basketball belongs to the Wonder Boys. It'll be Dylan Gooding to bring it into the front court. Gooding with 6 points so far tonight. Defended by Jermalle Norwood as they come across the timeline. Gooding dribbles left wing, throws it out front for Kevin McNeil. McNeil wants to drive, cut off by Gwynn, gives it out to Sandifer. Sandifer on to Gooding, three-pointer no good from the left corner. Derek Gwynn gets the defensive rebound for Champion Christian. Norwood passes over the timeline to Kentrell Jacobs. Skip pass left side for Gwynn, three-pointer short, no good. Devontae Foster gets the defensive rebound for Arkansas Tech. Long outlet pass ahead received by McNeil. McNeil dribbles into the right corner, finds the trailer Foster. Foster fakes a three, goes to the rim, scoops it up, and draws the foul against Dermarchio DeVoyle. It'll be DeVoyle's third. Team foul number three, and Devontae Foster gets himself to the free throw line for two shots. It'll draw a change in the Champion Christian lineup momentarily as Devontae Foster steps to the free throw line, where he is 1-for-2 so far tonight. Foster with 7 points and 7 rebounds in the game. His first free throw is good as he rattles it home. DeVoyle will check out with 3 fouls. He is replaced by Jordan McCray, who is in for the first time, a 6'3" freshman forward from Dallas, Texas. Devontae Foster seeks his 9th point of the game. He has got it. The Wonder Boys have scored 13 unanswered points. And with 18:40 remaining, it's an 8-point lead for Arkansas Tech. Top of the key.
KCJC, Darknell, Russellville. It's all of today's best country.
It's just my country.
On River Country, KCJC.
Derek Gwynn with a drive and a basket for Champion Christian. Cutting the Arkansas Tech lead back down to 6 at 47-41. Left wing Gooding shoots for 3. It rims out no good. Rebound, Arkansas Tech. Ramsey Sandifer has it. Double teamed on the baseline. Goes to the rim. Missed the shot. Rebound loose. Foster gets it for Tech. Out to Gooding. He fakes a three. Gives the corner for McNeil. And a whistle. And before the shot, a foul against Champion Christian. They've got a pushing foul on Jermali Norwood. It is his third personal foul. He had no fouls at halftime. He's committed three in the first minute 59 of the second half.
Been active, hasn't he?
And the basketball will be thrown in for Arkansas Tech by R.J. Glasper as they take a moment to try to address the perspiration on the floor here at Tucker Coliseum. Hope you'll join us here at Tucker Coliseum on Sunday afternoon for what promises to be a very good women's game between Arkansas Tech and Angelo State.
Angelo State, always good. Year in, year out. They're going to be bringing a tough team in here on Sunday. Come on out. We need a good crowd.
That'll be a 2 p.m. tip-off on Sunday afternoon here at Tucker Coliseum. If you can't make it, we will have the broadcast here on River Country KCJC and ArkansasTechSports.com.
That's number four.
Jermali Norwood picks up his fourth personal foul, all of which have come in the last 2 minutes and 5 seconds. And he'll have to check out, replaced by Corey Griggs. And that's a big loss for the Tigers as their starting point guard out now with four fouls and almost 18 minutes to go. The basketball belongs to Arkansas Tech. Wonder Boys lead 47-41, 17:45 to go, second half. Glasper drives, gets to the rim, layup will not go. Rebound by Griggs of Champion Christian. He leads a two-on-one, poked away from behind and stolen by Devontae Foster. Foster's alley pass stolen by Griggs. Griggs goes to the rim for Champion Christian and draws a foul against Devontae Foster. The foul on Foster is his second personal foul. Team foul number one this half.
He was guaranteeing himself he would not make that basket.
The shooter will be Corey Griggs, who absorbed that contact.
Ooh.
Griggs' first trip to the free throw line tonight. He makes the first one. Griggs was just 1 out of 5 from the free throw line in the Tigers' game against Harding University in Searcy on Tuesday night at Rhodes Reeves Fieldhouse. He makes both of those, and it's down to a 4-point lead for Arkansas Tech with 17:26 to go. Sandifer for three, good from the top of the key. Ramsey Sandifer buries the three. He's got 7 points. That's his first three-pointer of the game, his seventh of the season. And the Wonder Boys lead 50-43 with 17:10 to go. Drive by Griggs, throws it out in the right corner for Stephon Tellis. Now left side for Kentrell Jacobs. He lets the defender go by, misses the three. Tellis gets the offensive rebound. Pass deflected by Gooding. Stolen by Glasper. Ahead to McNeil. He stuffs it through. Kevin McNeil with the slam dunk in transition. And the Wonder Boys lead by 9, 52-43 on a slam dunk that brought this Tucker Coliseum crowd to its feet.
Oh, a great crowd tonight. Appreciate everybody coming out.
Particularly a very good student crowd here tonight. Left wing. With the basketball, Gwynn throws it cross-court for Griggs. Griggs looks to drive, cut off by Dylan Gooding. Loses the handle, and it's stolen away for Arkansas Tech by R.J. Glasper. 3-on-2 to McNeil. He lays it up and in. Back-to-back transition buckets for Kevin McNeil, and a timeout taken by Champion Christian. 16 minutes and 16 seconds to go. Second half, Arkansas Tech 54, Champion Christian 43. Back in 1 minute, you're listening to the Wonder Boys.
Miller Roofing Company. They've been serving our neighbors in the River Valley since 1991. Miller Roofing offers residential and commercial roofs in a variety of styles, pitched, flat roofs, and more, plus a wide variety of materials, tile, shingles, metals, you name it. Also at Miller Roofing, they do chimney caps, wood repair, they work on your gutters, they do custom metal fabrication, chimney flashing, and tons more. So get a quote today from Miller Roofing. They're not just good. They're great. 479-890-3499.
This is Todd Bimerstorf, Market President with Centennial Bank. And one of the best things about being a community-focused bank like Centennial is that we can focus on what matters, real relationships. That means the focus is on you as the customer. At Centennial Bank, we're real bankers helping people by building real relationships. Come see for yourself the difference our real commitment can make. Stop by any of our local branches in Russellville, Adkins, Pottsville, Clarksville, or Dardanelle. Or if you prefer, experience us online at my100bank.com. Centennial Bank, member FDIC.
Arkansas Tech in the midst of a 7-0 run that has included a three-pointer by Ramsey Sandifer and back-to-back transition buckets by Kevin McNeil. McNeil now with 6 points on the night, and it's 54-43 Arkansas Tech with 16 minutes and 10 seconds to go. Griggs drives, throws it out right wing for McCray. His three-pointer is no good. Rebound saved in by McNeil. Loose ball collected for Champion Christian by McCray, and he was fouled from behind on a push by Devontae Foster. Foster's third, team foul number two, and the Wonder Boys about to make a change. In for the first time tonight for Arkansas Tech is Cameron Kennedy. Kennedy did not play in the win over Emporia State on Saturday. He did appear in the season opening game against Fort Hays State. Kennedy is a 6'7" junior forward from Little Elm, Texas. And on the inbounds pass, a whistle and a foul and a three-point play opportunity for the Tigers. A pushing foul against Arkansas Tech's R.J. Glasper. His second personal foul, team foul number three. And it's Cameron Dismuke who will have the three-point play opportunity for the Tigers when we come back. 15 minutes and 59 seconds to go. Second half, timeout on the floor. Arkansas Tech 54, Champion Christian 45. Back in 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Basketball.
Corey Beeson and the folks at Beeson Roofing Solutions are proud to support local sports in the River Valley. And they also want to say a special thank you to all their loyal customers and the community for their business. So if you have a problem with your roof, whether it be on your home or business, visit BeesonRoofing.com to see their work or call 967-2288 to schedule a free estimate or second opinion today from your local roofing experts, Beeson Roofing Solutions.
How many times have you had to go without your heating or your air unit when you needed it most? Your family's freezing or sweating and they look to you for relief. You call someone and they say it's going to cost an arm and a leg to fix. Do you really feel like you have a choice? Well, now you do. Call Tony at Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air at 479-964-4004 for a free second opinion from a guy you can trust to take care of you and your family and get that unit running without all the extra charges. Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air.
15 minutes and 59 seconds to go in the second half. Arkansas Tech 54 and Champion Christian 45. And Cameron Dismuke at the free throw line shooting one, trying to complete a three-point play wrapped around the under 16 media timeout. He is successful in that effort. Cameron Dismuke with that free throw now has 6 points on the night. And it's 54-46 Arkansas Tech with 15:55 to go. Left wing R.J. Glasper gets a pick from Ramsey Sandifer. Uses it to put up a three. It is short, no good. Offensive rebound, Dylan Gooding. Gooding dribbles on the left wing after a long rebound. Came out to the freshman from Killeen, Texas. He drives the baseline, gets to the rim, and draws a foul. It'll be two free throws for Dylan Gooding. The foul on Champion Christian is on Jordan McCray. His first, team foul number six. And Dylan Gooding to the free throw line for the first time tonight. And for, in fact, the first time as a Wonder Boy, did not attempt a free throw in either the game against Fort Hays State or the game against Emporia State last weekend. Games the Wonder Boys split, losing to Fort Hays State last Friday night before bouncing back to defeat Emporia State on Saturday.
One thing you mentioned earlier, the points off turnovers. Wonder Boys continue that spread. They have a 17 points to zero. Champion Christian.
Tony Hall replaces Kevin McNeil in the Arkansas Tech lineup. The second free throw also good for Dylan Gooding. He gets both of those and pushes the Arkansas Tech lead back up to 10. With just under 15 and a half minutes to go, Jacobs pulls the trigger on a three. It is no good off to the right. Rebound is out of bounds off Arkansas Tech. And the basketball will remain with the Tigers. 20 on the shot clock, 15 minutes and 16 seconds left in the game, and Arkansas Tech leading 56-46. Inbound pass will be made for the Tigers by Corey Griggs, looking for Cameron Dismuke, but Glasper won't let him have it, so they throw it out near midcourt for Jordan McCray. McCray hands it off to Kentrell Jacobs, cross-court pass for for Gwynn. Derek Gwynn drives, fadeaway jumper good from the left baseline, an eight-footer for Gwynn. And with 15:06 to go, it's 56-48, Wonder Boys by eight. Drive, Glasper pass intercepted by Griggs. Corey Griggs the other way, finds Dismuke on the right wing. Crossover dribble, gets to the rim and draws a blocking foul against Arkansas Tech. It'll be on Ramsey Sandifer. Sandifer gets his. You got him for two or three, Kelly?
Got him for two.
Second personal foul on Sandifer, and that is correct. They were just quick putting it on the board. That's what made me second guess myself. It is Sandifer's second personal foul. It is team foul number four. And Dismuke to the free throw line. The first of two on its way and good for Cameron Dismuke. He is two out of two at the free throw line tonight. And that is 7 points for the freshman from Buckner, Arkansas. DeMarcio DeVoyle returns for the Tigers. For the Wonder Boys, it is Devontae Foster in place of Ramsey Sandifer. Second try forthcoming for Cameron Dismuke. Goes through his pre-shot routine, cuts it loose. It is good as he gets a friendly roll. And with 14 minutes and 50 seconds to go, it's back down to a six-point lead for Arkansas Tech. Gooding drives hard to the rim and draws a foul. He will have two free throws. The foul on Champion Christian is on Cameron Dismuke. He gets his second personal foul. It's team foul number seven, and so the Wonder Boys will be in the bonus. And for Champion Christian, they're going to make a change on the lane. They want Derek Gwynn up there to rebound instead of Cameron Dismuke before Dylan Gooding attempts the first of these two free throws. The first one on its way and no good for Gooding. He's now two out of three at the free throw line. He has 8 points. Gooding came in averaging 16.5 points per game through the first two contests of the year for Arkansas Tech. He misses both of those. Champion Christian clears the rebound, and here comes Corey Griggs. Griggs across the timeline, behind the back dribble, passes right wing for DeMarcio DeVoyle. Pass out front deflected by Tony Hall. DeVoyle able to save the loose ball for the Tigers.
Good defense by the Wonder Boys.
Now Dismuke with it, 10 on the shot clock, gets a pick from DeVoyle. Dismuke drives, ball fake, got his defender in the air, and Devontae Foster fouled him. That is the fourth personal foul on Devontae Foster. It comes with 14 minutes and 21 seconds to go. And he'll be replaced by Ramsey Sandifer. It is team foul number five. And Dismuke back to the free throw line where he is three out of three so far tonight. Champion Christian as a team, seven out of seven at the free throw line tonight. Make it eight out of eight as Dismuke gets his ninth point. And now he'll have a chance to become the third Tiger into double figures. It's almost celebration time in Magnolia, isn't it there, Kelly?
Getting close. 23-16 in the third set.
The Golden Suns can get to 25 there. They will win the set. They will win the match. And they will make their travel plans for Hot Springs and the Great American Conference Volleyball Tournament next week.
More than likely taking on Oklahoma Baptist.
Three-pointer on the way. No good for Tony Hall. Both free throws were good for Dismuke. Champion Christian is on a 6-0 run. Jacobs will try to add to it, and he does. Kentrell Jacobs with a three-pointer from deep on the right wing, his sixth three-pointer of the night, and the Wonder Boys' lead is down to a single point. Glasper drives and scores with the left hand. A floater from 6 feet away in the middle of the lane for R.J. Glasper. He has 13 points. He's 5 out of 10 from the field, and the Wonder Boys' lead 58-55 with 13:39 to go. Cameron Dismuke drives and dishes, gives to Jacobs on the right wing. Out front it goes to Gwynn. Now in the left corner for Dismuke. Dismuke defended by R.J. Glasper. Dismuke drives, and they're going to call him for an offensive foul. Cameron Dismuke called for the push-off.
It'll be his third.
And it is team foul number eight due to the nature of the foul. No free throws for Arkansas Tech. Sandifer and Hall check out for the Wonder Boys. As back in are Kevin McNeil and Cameron Kennedy. So it's Dylan Gooding, Cameron Kennedy, Kevin McNeil, Ramsey Sandifer, and R.J. Glasper. The five on the floor for the Wonder Boys. Gooding dribbles right, gives it up in the corner for Neal. He shoots from 10 feet, no good. Offensive rebound, Cameron Kennedy. And on the putback try, Kennedy is fouled. Call on Champion Christian is against Derek Gwynn. That is his second personal foul. It is team foul number 9. One more will put Arkansas Tech into the double bonus.
Kennedy from Little Elm, Texas. Where is that, you think?
Somewhere in the Lone Star State. I know.
Down by Big Elm?
I'm more familiar with where he went to junior college. He went to Seminole State College there in Seminole, Oklahoma. He averaged 7.7 points and 3.1 rebounds per game there last year. We passed through that community last Saturday on our way to East Central University for the football game. Kennedy's first free throw is no good. He will have another try.
Golden Suns are headed to the GAC volleyball tournament. 25-16 final score in the third set. They win the match 3-0.
Congratulations to head coach Kara Dukic and the Golden Suns. Back here in Russellville, a 1 out of 2 trip to the free throw line for Cameron Kennedy. It's 59-55 Wonder Boys as we go under 13 minutes to play. Drive by Corey Grigg, circles underneath the basket, throws it out to Jacobs, three-pointer, no good, long rebound off the back lip. Gooding gets the defensive rebound, finds Glasper in transition, RJ to the rim, lays it up and in. RJ Glasper with 15 points to lead the Wonder Boys, 12:43 to go, and it's a 61-55 Arkansas Tech lead. Drive by Gwynn, throws it in the corner for Jordan McCray, who checked back in at the last dead ball in place of DeMarcio DeVoyle. Three-pointer good for Cameron Dismuke. He knocks it down from deep on the right wing, and in so doing, cuts the Arkansas Tech lead in half. It's 61-58 Wonder Boys with 12:15 to go. Glasper fakes a three, drives, gets to the rim, misses the layup, and it's a blocking foul against Champion Christian. They're going to get Corey
11.
Griggs. It is Griggs first. It is team foul number 10, and so the Wonder Boys will shoot two free throws the rest of the way.
He was in good shape. He was just inside the circle.
And that is an easy call once you're inside that restricted area.
Semi-circle,
yep.
I must say.
Half circle.
Half moon?
Yeah.
No quarter moons out here.
Nope. Glasper will shoot two once they get the perspiration wiped up off the floor. And after he attempts the first one, we'll have some changes for the Wonder Boys.
Full moons are outside.
Yes. And
occasionally.
You want to do the weather while you're at it?
I can. You want me
to? I know you can.
I can be just as right.
Glasper makes the first free throw. The end of the game for the first time tonight for Arkansas Tech is Calvin Allen, a 5'11 sophomore from Little Rock. Calvin made his Wonder Boys debut against Emporia State on Saturday and played 2 minutes. Back in for the Wonder Boys is Kyler Haynes. First free throw good for Glasper. The second one with 12:11 to go is also good. 63-58 Wonder Boys with 12:11 to go. So it's Calvin Allen, RJ Glasper, Kyler Haynes, Ramsey Sandifer, and Kevin McNeil, the five on the floor for Tech. Jumper in the lane, no good for Griggs. Rebound Sandifer, long outlet for Glasper. He floats it for McNeil, and on the alley-oop, Kevin McNeil stuffs it through. The Wonder Boys score in transition, and they lead by 7. Dismuke tries to answer with a three. It is short, no good. And on the rebound, a whistle and a foul against Jordan McCray of Champion Christian. His second, and there's timeout on the floor. 11:43 remaining, second half. Arkansas Tech 65, Champion Christian 58. We pause for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Basketball.
Fellner's Athletes Corner, your high-performance athletic store for quality athletic footwear and apparel, features Nike, Under Armour, The North Face, Patagonia, Oakley, Saucony, New Balance, Brooks, Asics, Kabu, Keen, and many, many more. Fellner's invites you to make them your first stop. With more than 50 years combined experience, the familiar faces at Fellner's can help you with all your athletic needs. Fellner's Athletes Corner, 2320 West Main, Russellville, open 9:30 until 6, Monday through Saturday.
Hey, it's Drew Mitchell for Lakeside Oral Facial and Dental Implant Surgery. Lakeside is really proud this year to be sponsoring our local sports all throughout the River Valley. They're committed to the area. It's just another way they show that. When you're in the market for dentures, wisdom teeth, or whatever the case may be, remember Lakeside Oral Facial and Dental Implant Surgery and check out their website at lakesideofs.com. Lakeside Oral Surgery, helping make the broadcast of local sports throughout the River Valley possible.
11 minutes and 43 seconds remaining. Arkansas Tech 65, Champion Christian 58. And Ramsey Sandifer at the free throw line to shoot two following the under 12 media timeout. Sandifer so far tonight on behalf of Arkansas Tech University has 7 points. Now make it 8 as he connects on his first free throw try of the game. He is 8 out of 10 at the free throw line this season. Now he is 9 out of 11. He makes both of those, and the Wonder Boys lead by 9, 67 to 58. The Wonder Boys have led by as many as 11. Into the front court come the Tigers. At the controls, top of the key is Arian Williams. They get it down low to Dismuke. He lays it up and in. Cameron Dismuke with 15 points for Champion Christian. And the Wonder Boys lead 67-60, make it 70-60 as Ramsey Sandifer reins in a three-pointer from the left wing. And the Wonder Boys lead is 10. Ramsey Sandifer becomes the fourth Wonder Boy into double figures. He hits his second three-pointer of the night. He's got 10 points in all. Missed three by Champion Christian. Rebound McNeil in transition. His pass is intercepted by Kentrell Jacobs. And Jacobs, harassed in the backcourt, has to give it up to Arian Williams. Into the front court for Griggs. He pulls up from the right wing, shoots and misses from 16 feet. The rebound is out of bounds on the baseline, and it will belong to Arkansas Tech. 10 minutes and 50 seconds to go. Arkansas Tech 70, Champion Christian 60. Wonder Boys trying to get to 2-1 on the year. Glasper shoots for three. It is short, no good. Tip in is good by Kyler Haynes. Haynes gets his first 2 points of the night, his fourth rebound of the game. And it's 72-60 as the Wonder Boys have their largest lead so far, a 12-point spread with 10:23 to go. On the right wing, Dismuke. Defended by Haynes. Drives, throws it in the corner for Griggs. Three-pointer, short, no good. Defensive rebound by Calvin Allen. Outlet for Glasper. He gives to McNeil, and Kevin McNeil once again stuffs it through for Arkansas Tech. 10 minutes and 8 seconds to go, and the Wonder Boys lead by 14.
He got his money's worth on that one.
Ball out of bounds on the near sideline. Last touch by Champion Christian's Corey Griggs, and it starts to feel like the Wonder Boys' superior depth is starting to take its toll on the Tigers.
Looked like a little fatigue setting in.
Wonder Boys right now on a 7-0 spurt and a 13-2 run over the last 2.5 minutes. Glasper with it on the left wing. Looks to drive, dishes out for Sandifer. Three-pointer is good. Ramsey Sandifer with 13 points, his third three-pointer of the game, and it's 77-60. The Wonder Boys taking control. It'll be Stephon Tellis over the timeline on the dribble for the Tigers. Checked by Glasper. Goes to the left wing. McNeil takes him on a switch. Tellis goes right, hands it off to Jacobs, and Tellis was guilty of setting a moving screen for his third personal foul. And the basketball goes back to Arkansas Tech with 9 minutes and 27 seconds to go. And the Wonder Boys looking to add to a 16-2 spurt that has lasted now for 2 minutes and 44 seconds.
Ben,
yes, sir.
What conference are they in?
They do not compete. Are you talking about Champion Christian?
I was about to say, they're going to win several games this year, I think.
They do not compete in a conference. They do compete in the National Christian College Athletic Association, and there's a national tournament for that at the end of the year, and so that's what they're pointing toward. Drive by Calvin Allen. Cut off by Stephon Tellis. Shot clock at 20. Bounce pass out to Glasper. Sandifer ready with the ball screen for Glasper if he wants it. He does, goes right, gives to Sandifer on a pick and roll, and he stuffs it through. Ramsey Sandifer with 15 points, the latest two coming emphatically on a slam dunk. And Arkansas Tech leads 79-60. Left wing, Dismuke for three. It is no good. Rebound, whistle, and a foul against Arkansas Tech.
And a push off somewhere in there.
Kevin McNeil, the guilty party. He pushed off to get that rebound in the estimation of the official. It is McNeil's second, team foul number six. And the basketball belongs to Champion Christian. R.J. Glasper will get a much-deserved breather. Glasper with a double-double tonight, 17 points and 10 assists. Left wing three by Dismuke is no good. Rebound, Arkansas Tech. Kyler Haynes got it. I should say Kevin McNeil got it. And McNeil's pass in transition deflected out. And let's see what we've got here. The official going over to the official book. Believe just a warning of some kind.
Well, I think when he called it a flop, do they get warnings now? Is that a new rule this year, maybe?
Yeah, that's,
if it's an obvious flop like that?
Cameron Dismuke is going to check out.
We're going to have to get a rule book.
I tell you what, they like to change those rules every year, don't they? Whistle.
Ramsey.
Whistle and an illegal screen set by Ramsey Sandifer. It is his third personal foul.
Didn't mean to, I'm sure.
Team foul number seven against Arkansas Tech. And the basketball belongs to Champion Christian with 8 minutes and 28 seconds to go. And the Wonder Boys now seemingly in control on an 18-2 run and leading 79-60. And a foul committed 94 feet from the basket by Arkansas Tech's Kyler Haynes that will gift wrap a 1-1 opportunity for the Tigers.
That'll give you gray hair if you're a coach.
The foul on Haynes is his first. And Jamali Norwood to the free throw line for Champion Christian. You wonder how different this night might have been for the Tigers if Norwood hadn't picked up those four quick fouls at the beginning of this second half.
Yeah, and Jacobs, number 22, he kind of cooled off a little bit after that outstanding start.
Norwood makes both free throws. And with 8:26 to go, it is 79-62, a 17-point lead for Arkansas Tech. Wonder Boys get it over the timeline. Kyler Haynes walked with the basketball. Just the fifth turnover of the entire game for Arkansas Tech compared to 17 turnovers for Champion Christian, the Wonder Boys with a 23-2 edge in points off turnovers.
No doubt he did walk.
R.J. Glasper will replace Calvin Allen in the Arkansas Tech lineup. 79-62 is the Arkansas Tech lead with 8 minutes and 15 seconds to go. Into the front court on the dribble. It'll be Stephon Tellis. Tellis checked by R.J. Glasper. Looks to drive, 19 to shoot, Tellis into the painted area, gets the layup try up, it is good. R.J. Glasper could not have defended that one any better. In fact, he even got a hand on the basketball as Tellis was going up.
Good drive.
Tellis able to score nonetheless. He has 6 points. Glasper floats it up to the rim, and there's Kyler Haynes to tip it in. 11th assist of the night for R.J. Glasper. Haynes has 4 points, and it's 81-64 Arkansas Tech with 7:36 to go. Top of the key, Jermail Norwood on the dribble, gives in the right corner. Three-pointer is no good for Stephon Tellis, but there with the tip in for Champion Christian was Derek Gwynn. It's a 15-point lead again for the Wonder Boys at 81-66 with 7:16 to play. Dylan Gooding, Kevin McNeil, Ramsey Sandifer, Kyler Haynes, and R.J. Glasper are the five on the floor for the Wonder Boys. Gooding drives. Dishes out for McNeil. Three-pointer left corner is no good. Defensive rebound by Corey Griggs of Champion Christian. Tigers into the front court. Bounce pass ahead for Gwynn. Rejected out of bounds by Ramsey Sandifer. And that'll take us to a timeout on the floor. 6 minutes and 52 seconds to play. Arkansas Tech 81. Champion Christian 66. We pause for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Basketball.
Joshua's Fine Jewelry, a luxury establishment in the heart of downtown Russellville, are taking it back to the good old days with a family-owned, family-operated business that pride themselves on personal interactions, beautiful custom craftsmanship, and an insanely knowledgeable and helpful staff that go above and beyond just for you. Joshua's Fine Jewelry is giving a huge shout-out to all of our local River Valley and Natural State athletes. You guys are the real MVPs. Be sure to like Joshua's Fine Jewelry on Facebook today and go and give them a visit in downtown Russellville at 310 West Main Street.
Did you know if your roof isn't maintained regularly, you could void the warranty on your existing roof? Tim Noblett with E&F Roofing has made it his mission to protect your roof or help you get the new roof that will maximize your investment and extend the life of your roof, which can save you money through prevention and maintenance. So before you have another company check your roof, call 479-272-4069 and let E&F Roofing see what they can find and how much you can save by using someone local, someone who cares, right here in the River Valley.
6 minutes and 52 seconds to go in the ball game. Arkansas Tech 81, Champion Christian 66. Reminder, we've got Wonder Boys football for you Saturday afternoon at 2 at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field. Harding University will be the opponent. And then Golden Suns basketball at 2 p.m. on Sunday against Angelo State University. Both of those broadcasts here on River Country, KCJC, and ArkansasTechSports.com. But we'd love to see you at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field on Saturday, as well as right here at Tucker Coliseum on Sunday afternoon. And, of course, party at the Plaza will begin at noon on Saturday, tailgating on the Crayball Hall lawn. We'd like to see you for that as well. Jacobs for three. He gets the bounce. Kentrell Jacobs has 25 points to lead all scorers, and he cuts the Arkansas Tech lead down to a dozen. Gooding shoots and scores, a 12-footer in the lane for Dylan Gooding as he answers for Arkansas Tech. And it's 83-69 Wonder Boys with 6 minutes and 20 seconds to go. Gooding with 10 points. He's the fifth Wonder Boy in double figures. Left baseline drive by Gwynn. Shot is blocked by Gooding. Gooding saves it in, but right to Griggs of Champion Christian. Now a pass stolen for Arkansas Tech by R.J. Glasper. It's a 5-on-3. Glasper to the rim, feeds Devontae Foster, and he stuffs it through. 11 points for Devontae Foster. That's now 6 Wonder Boys in double figures. It's 12 assists for Glasper. Glasper in transition will miss the layup. Gooding gets the rebound, puts it back up, no good. Rebound, Champion Christian. Coming away with the loose ball was Corey Griggs. In transition, layup up and good for Stephon Tellis. And with 5:39 to go, it's 85-71. Now a steal for Champion Christian by Jamal Norwood. Norwood gives it up, and in transition, layup up and good for Stephon Tellis, and a timeout taken by Arkansas Tech. 5:25 to go. Arkansas Tech 85, Champion Christian 73. Back in 1 minute, you're listening to the Wonder Boys.
Why trust River Valley Tinting and Glass? Well, River Valley Tinting and Glass is a family-owned business, and they take care of their customers like family, too. So remember, your local auto, residential, and commercial glass and tinting company, River Valley Tinting and Glass. Check out their work on Facebook or call 890-5839 to get an estimate. Or you could always come by 2202 East 2nd Street to see all they can do for you. From a business you can trust, River Valley Tinting and Glass.
Taking care of families. That's what the folks at C&D Drugstore have been doing in historic downtown Russellville for more than 6 decades when it comes to all your pharmaceutical needs. When it comes to compounding special medicines, R.D. Walker and his staff are there to serve you. And most importantly, if you need delivery, if you need curbside pickup, you need C&D Drugstore on the corner of B and Commerce in downtown Russellville, a 60-year tradition.
5 minutes and 25 seconds remaining. Arkansas Tech 85, Champion Christian 73. Head coach Chad Klein calling that timeout after things had gotten sloppy for just a moment.
Refocus.
Inbound pass for R.J. Glasper. Glasper defended in the backcourt by Jamal Norwood. Wonder Boys into the front court now. Glasper with it on the right wing. Gives it up top to keeper Dylan Gooding. Both teams have been exclusively man-to-man defensively here tonight. Top of the key, Glasper with nine to shoot, drives, dishes for Tony Hall. Hall might have got away with a traveling violation, gives to Glasper for three. It is good. R.J. Glasper with the three-pointer from the left wing. Glasper now with 20 points on the night. This is the 26th time in his Arkansas Tech career that he has scored 20 or more points. And the Wonder Boys lead by 15 with 4:42 to go. Now a steal by Tony Hall, and in transition, a foul committed by Champion Christian's Corey Griggs. The foul on Champion Christian will result in two free throws. The foul on Griggs is his second, and Tony Hall will be at the free throw line for the first time tonight. Hall is 0-for-1 at the free throw line so far this season. Hall is a 6'5" junior guard from Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. He averaged 13.6 points and 13.5 points per game the last 2 years at Northern Oklahoma College before transferring here to Arkansas Tech, averaging 6.5 points per game early in this season for the Wonder Boys. He missed the first free throw and will have another opportunity as Cameron Dismuke returns for the Tigers and gives Derek Gwynn a breather just ahead of the under four media timeout. Hall makes the second free throw, 4:39 to go. 89-73 is the Arkansas Tech lead. Over the timeline on the dribble comes Jermail Norwood. Right side, dribble penetration by Tellis. Can't get the floater to go from the right side of the lane. Dylan Gooding forced the miss, and Devontae Foster rebounded it. Into the front court, loose ball stolen by Jermail Norwood. Norwood goes coast to coast, layup try no good. Rebound by Arkansas Tech's Devontae Foster. They take it away from him, off the window and good for Champion Christian by Kentrell Jacobs. Jacobs now with that bucket has 27 points. He is 10 out of 14 from the floor, and it's an 18-point lead. Correction, a 14-point lead for Arkansas Tech. Now it's a 16-point lead as Kevin McNeil stuffs it through on the other end. And it is 91-75 Wonder Boys with 3:45 to go. A whistle and a traveling violation against Champion Christian, and there's timeout on the floor, 3:39 to go. Our score is Arkansas Tech 91, Champion Christian 75. We pause for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Basketball.
How can I help you?
Can you turn on the porch light? I can't see anything.
Sorry, I didn't get that.
Ow! Not every innovation is helpful, but the new ITMs at First State Bank can help you achieve your banking needs at the push of a button. Interact with local tellers, cash a check, and more right from your car. Plus, ITMs are open weekdays from 7 to 7. To learn more about First State Bank's new innovative services, go to fsbitm.com.
For over 70 years, Old South Restaurant at 1330 East Main Street in Russellville has been faithfully serving the River Valley. Whether it's starting your day with a good old-fashioned breakfast or helping you make it through the workday with a hearty home-styled lunch, and of course serving your family with a dinner that would even make your mama proud. Old South Restaurants on Main Street in Russellville. We're here for you.
We're here for you, so come on by Old South.
3 minutes and 39 seconds to go in the second half. Arkansas Tech 91 and Champion Christian 75. Glad you've been able to join us tonight here on River Country KCJC as well as ArkansasTechSports.com.
Little fatigue set in. The points off turnover, Wonder Boys 25 to 8, and also fast break points 21 to 8.
Wonder Boys beat the press, get it ahead for McNeil. McNeil throws it out to Sandifer. Now they bring it back out to the perimeter for R.J. Glasper, and the Wonder Boys will practice running some clock here. Shot clock's down to 13. Glasper spreads the floor, dribbles on the Tech logo at midcourt. He's defended by Cameron Dismuke, shoots over him for three. It is good. 23 points and 12 assists tonight for R.J. Glasper.
And not a bad night.
Not bad at all. And a 19-point lead for the Wonder Boys with 3 minutes to go. Drive by Griggs, gives to Dismuke in the right corner. He passes back to Griggs, who has it now on the right wing. Bounce pass down low. Layup is up and good for Jacobs. Kentrell Jacobs with 29 points to lead all scorers. And it's 94-77. Wonder Boys beat the press. Gooding into the front court. Penetrates. Bounce pass out in the corner. And now the Wonder Boys will work on that clock. Shot clock at 14. Glasper gets it on the Tech logo at midcourt. Blows by his defender. Feeds McNeil. He lays it up and in. 16 points tonight for Kevin McNeil. A new season high for the senior from San Bernardino, California. And it's 96-77 Wonder Boys with 2:15 to go. Dismuke in the right corner shoots and misses from 16 feet. Defensive rebound for Arkansas Tech by Tony Hall. The Wonder Boys with the win will improve to 2-1 on the season. And they will now have a week to further polish things and refine things before they begin Great American Conference play 1 week from tonight against Ouachita Baptist University. Stephon Tellis takes a foul for Champion Christian. And it'll be two free throws for Arkansas Tech's R.J. Glasper. Game time next Thursday night for the Wonder Boys next game will be 7:30 p.m. That'll be game two of a doubleheader in Great American Conference play. The Golden Suns will take on the Ouachita women at 5:30 next Thursday. The Golden Suns have one more tune-up between now and then. They will entertain Angelo State at 2 p.m. on Sunday right here at Tucker Coliseum.
Better tighten those shoestrings.
Golden Suns off to a 2-0 start this year and looking for what could be a very valuable in-region win if they can get it over Angelo State on Sunday. 98-77. Glasper makes both free throws. He now has 25 points and 13 assists. Pass on the right wing for Cameron Dismuke. A minute and a half left in this one. Left wing, pass received by Jacobs, three-pointer no good. R.J. Glasper with the defensive rebound, and he'll look to slow it down. A minute 22 to go. About the only mystery left now is whether or not the Wonder Boys will hit the 100-point mark. Glasper, defended by Jermail Norwood, gets by him and lays it up and in. 27 points for Glasper, and the Wonder Boys do indeed get to 100. 100-77 is our score. Now a steal. Kevin McNeil will bring it the other way for the Wonder Boys. We're under a minute to go. And the Wonder Boys tonight using their defense to create offense. 28 points off turnovers tonight for the Wonder Boys as they forced Champion Christian into 21 turnovers while committing just 7 of their own. Left wing Gooding with it. Been balanced scoring here tonight for the Wonder Boys. 6 in double figures, led by Glasper's 27. Three-pointer no good for Gooding as the shot clock was about to expire. Rebound is out of bounds, last touched by the Tigers. And the Wonder Boys will have it as they put the shot clock at 20. Glasper will check out, capping a fine night for the junior from Forest City. 27 points on 9 of 16 shooting from the floor. He was 5 of 9 from three-point range. He also dished out 13 assists. Gooding receives the inbounds pass. Wonder Boys will either have to shoot it or allow the shot clock to expire. 9 on the shot clock, 15 seconds left in the game. Drive, layup is up and good for Dylan Gooding. And he'll have a chance at a three-point play as they call a foul against Champion Christian. They called it on Ezekiel Capasi, who just checked in for the first time. A 5'11 freshman guard from Hot Springs picks up the foul. The free throw is no good. The rebound is out of bounds. Last touched by Champion Christian. Now the Wonder Boys will have the opportunity to allow the clock to expire without having to take another shot. 102-77 is our score as Cameron Kennedy checks in. In for the first time tonight for the Wonder Boys is Caleb Turner, a 6'3" sophomore guard from Bryant. Caleb, during pregame warm-ups, asked me for a shout-out on the radio. This is it, Caleb. Tony Hall gets the inbound pass, and he will dribble out the final seconds, passes it right side to McNeil, and that'll do it. Final score tonight from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville is Arkansas Tech, 102, Champion Christian 77 back in 1 minute with Coach Klein. Wonder Boys win. This is Arkansas Tech basketball.
This is Adam Stoffel with Phil Wright Autoplex. This month only, up to $8,500 off 2020 Buick Conclaves, or 0% for 72 months on all remaining 2019 models. Or up to $10,000 off 2019 Buick Envisions, or 0% for 72 months. Register to win with your purchase of a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, Toyota, or pre-owned, a 2019 Polaris Sportsman, or Honda Rancher. Up to 30% off 2019 Buick Encores, or 0% for 72 months. Phil Wright Autoplex, exit 84, just off I-40 in Russellville.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service, we're more than just tires. Consistent, responsive, honest and fair. What makes us different? We're the ones who care. Trust our experience to know what you need. Professional and fast, see what we mean. Arkansas Tire and Auto Service. More than just tires.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service, 2304 East Main, Russellville.
Back with you at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, where the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys have defeated Champion Christian by a final score of 102-77. We are joined by Chad Klein, head coach of the Wonder Boys. And Coach, there was a span there midway through the second half when you went on an 18-2 run, opened up a 79-60 lead with 9 minutes to go. As you went through that stretch of the game, what did you see as the big difference that allowed your team to take control of this one?
We were getting stops. That's what we got to do. Scoring has never been an issue here, but when we don't get stops and just trade baskets, it's going to be a long night. We finally, you know, put our foot down a little bit, and we're able to keep them out of the paint. You know, in the first half, they got into the paint all night long, and when we'd help, they'd just pitch it for three. I think we were... You know, you try to not overlook anyone, but our guys aren't silly. You know, they see Hardy smash these guys the other night, and I think they thought it was just going to come in and be a cakewalk. And I tried to tell them, look, when people come in this building, it's one of the nicest arenas in the state. They never have a chance to play in here. It's their Super Bowl, and they came out, and I thought in the first half they played harder than us, and that's why the game was as close as it was. I thought in the second half we kind of flipped the switch and started playing harder, and that's how we were able to get some defensive stops. But, you know, with a whole new group of guys, it's a process for sure. You try to tell them, you tell them until you're blue in the face, but they really doesn't sink in until you come out and see it live.
R.J. Glasper had 27 points tonight, and that's wonderful. But the column that I'm most interested in, the two columns I'm most interested in, 13 assists and just one turnover tonight for RJ, and that tells me that he is starting to mesh with all of these new teammates that he has.
I think he knows he's got some other guys that can really score the ball. In the past, I think he's felt like he's had to take that burden on his own. 27 points on only 16 shots. You know, that's he knows he can do that. He doesn't have to be a volume scorer. He doesn't have to shoot it 25 times to get his points. And he's really grown up, and heck, we needed him tonight.
A week now to prepare for the Great American Conference opener as Ouachita Baptist will come in here next Thursday night. Coach Nutt always has a good team from down there in Arkadelphia. What are some of the things that you look to focus on in practice between now and next Thursday night?
Well, defense, Sam, and that's crazy because we worked on it for four straight days now, and I thought, after our Emporia State game, we were as good defensively last Saturday as we've been since I've been here. You know what we held them to 59 points and 30-some% shooting. So I really put an emphasis on that we're going to keep guarding people, and then we come out and obviously don't defend anybody. So that'll be an emphasis. Coach Nutt's teams are always well coached. They run a million set plays that you have to be ready for, and they really rebound it, and it's just. If we play like we played tonight, we'll get beat. So luckily, we didn't play them tonight. We got a week to prepare for them.
Well, congratulations on the win tonight. We'll see you then.
Thanks, Coach.
That is Chad Klein, the head men's basketball coach here at Arkansas Tech University, following a 102-77 win tonight over Champion Christian College. Let's take a look at the final numbers from this one. The Wonder Boys tonight were 38 of 75 from the floor. That is 51%, including 11 out of 30 from three-point range, 37%. And the Wonder Boys were 15 of 21, 71%, at the free throw line. Champion Christian, 28 of 59, 48% from the field, including 10 out of 27, 37% from three-point range. They made all 11 of their free throws tonight. Arkansas Tech finished with a 37-34 rebounding edge. Really, the story was told tonight in turnover margin. The Wonder Boys had just 7 turnovers, forced Champion Christian into 21, and the Wonder Boys finished with a 30-8 edge in points off turnovers. Individual leaders, first for Champion Christian, they put 3 in double figures, led by Kentrell Jacobs, who is phenomenal here tonight. 29 points on 11 of 16 shooting. He was 7 out of 12 from three-point range, and he also grabbed 9 rebounds. 15 points for Cameron Dismuke and 14 points for Derek Gwynn of Champion Christian. Arkansas Tech led by R.J. Glasper with 27 points and a career-high 13 assists. Kevin McNeil, the beneficiary of several of those assists, finished with a season-high 16 points. 15 points tonight for Ramsey Sandifer. Dylan Gooding had 12 points, 11 points for Devontae Foster, 12 points for Tony Hall. Those were the 6 Wonder Boys in double figures, including all 5 starters. 4 points tonight for Arkansas Tech's Kyler Haynes, 2 points in the game for Albert Odero, 2 points also tonight for Keelan Adams of Arkansas Tech, and Cameron Kennedy had 1 point as the Wonder Boys win it 102-77. Arkansas Tech goes to 2-1 on the year, and as we turn it over to Kelly Davis, Kelly, the other big headline from the night in Arkansas Tech athletics is congratulations to head coach Kara Dukic and the Golden Suns volleyball team as they are on their way back to the GAC tournament.
They improved to 16-13 on the year, 8-8 in conference play. And they will get that number 8 seed. UA Monticello was 6-9 coming into the matches tonight. So if they win, they will move to 7-9. So they'll be 1 game out. So it looks like the Golden Suns may be playing Oklahoma Baptist, number 1 seed in the GAC tournament. They come into the tournament now 13-2. An overall record of 24-5. So it'll be a tough task, but Golden Suns magic has, you never know when it's going to show up, right?
Well, congratulations to Coach Dukic and the Golden Suns as they make their way into the postseason with that win tonight at Southern Arkansas University. And here it was the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys 102 and the Champion Christian College Tigers 77. I want to send along special thanks to Mr. Paul Smith, the Associate Director of Athletics and Director of Athletic Communications here at Arkansas Tech University. He and his hardworking staff provided us with all of the facts and figures that we were able to share with you, and we thank him for his contributions to tonight's broadcast. We thank Mr. Stephen Berry, who did a great job, as always, as our Chief Studio Engineer. Thank you to the sponsors who make it possible, and thanks to you for listening. Our next broadcast of Arkansas Tech Athletics on River Valley Radio will come your way Saturday afternoon. It'll be a 1:30 pregame and a 2 p.m. kickoff as we wrap up the 105th season of Arkansas Tech football. The Wonder Boys and the Harding Bisons, 2 p.m. Saturday at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville, and right here on River Country KCJC and ArkansasTechSports.com. Until then, from my broadcast partner, Kelly Davis, I'm Sam Streisner, reminding you that Jerry says, fight on. So long, everybody.
River Valley radio coverage of